First of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. But I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs. So I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular. In other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hello lovely Libra, this is your reading for July 2017. Your Tarotscope, Angelscope, and quick astrological overview for the month of July. And what I actually felt before was it's as if all the sort of kind of astro vibe just came together in a sort of sentence, which was something like this. You may have lost your sense of feeling safe going out into the world with a big vision for your career, and July is where you begin to get that back. So I hope that makes sense. Because, right, just to break it down slightly, so you've got, so it's your 10th house, it's all about the 10th house for you for most of the month. And because we're looking at Cancer, which is about the emotions, nurturing, self-love, the family home, all those feelings of emotional security, this is what it feels like. It feels as if you need to step back out there. You need to step back out there because the world needs you to step back out there. So that's it. I'm going to shuffle the cards now and see what will help Libra. What will help Libra to, I've just heard, get out of your head. My guide said, get out of your head. Stop thinking so much. I thought that was the Gemini problem. They're saying Libra as well, right? So we know this. This is an air sign thing, isn't it? Sometimes. Don't want to stereotype you guys, but yeah, okay, get out of your head. Right, let's just shuffle and see. Right, I've just heard stop, that should do it. Right, so this is what we're looking at for you, Libra, for the month of July 2017. So we've got, we're in a place of material, financial and material changes, and I feel for you, just when I look at that and I'm asking, have they been good, are they not so good? I feel as if I'm on a boat, and I feel as if it's like, it's waves, it's choppy. The sea's choppy, it's too many changes, it's ups and downs, it's ups and downs, and it may have been that way for a while. I feel like I'm a bit seasick actually. Too many changes happening all the time, and it's like you think you're on dry land or firm footing, and then it's sort of like the rug gets pulled again. Sorry about all the mixed metaphors, but you know what I'm saying. It's there have been changes, and it feels as if you're still in a place of flux and change. I think this is the card that's the Five of Pentacles in the traditional deck. And, you know, when those people are standing outside that church and there's help, and it's very, very near, but they're so bruised and wounded they can't quite see it yet. And I feel this also refers to, it's not just about your material reality, it's about your ability to feel safe in the material world. This seems to be a bit of a theme for a lot of people at the moment, for a lot of signs, and it's manifesting in different ways. For you, it's like your whole sense of self, your whole centre is around that at the moment, because that's your main card. So let's see what else comes up, what crosses you for that. Accelerated motion, good. Something's about to change. Fantastic. So July is the month when it starts to feel a little bit firmer. That seems to be the way of it. So hopefully something good's about to come in for you, something good's about to materialise for you in July, Libra, that's going to help you to feel like you can move ahead again and quite quickly. And I'm just hearing, when you wish upon a star. So you've got a star here. It's almost like, you know, you're looking up there and you're thinking, when is it going to be, you know, which one is mine, which so many stars, which one is mine, when is it going to land, when am I going to feel settled in the new vision of my life, in my new creation, in all of these gifts and all of these possibilities and these ideas and these inspirations. And you know, maybe even there's some channeling, there's a lot there going on for you, and you have to get out of your head and trust everything that you know and everything that you've been created, because things are going to settle down, and when they settle down and you settle down within them, they are going to rocket forward. And I feel July is going to be a turning point for that. So what's over you? Oh, deception and envy, interesting. So this card's come up a few times this month. I would say just be very aware of keeping what you value close to your chest, is the way I'm hearing it for you. Keep it to yourself until you're really sure about it. Don't talk too much about your plans until you really know what they are. So I'm getting a sense that you're sort of talking about things and they're showing me hot air. It's like puff, puff, puff. You know, you don't talk too much about things, because you've got some great ideas around you at the moment. Great ideas, great insights, great possibilities for bringing people together as well. I'm hearing under an umbrella or something like that. Like, it's like you're wanting to create something, and you know, something that takes you out of a job and into your own space of creations. And you need to be really respectful of this stage of nurturing it, and don't talk about it until it's a done deal, in a sense, or at least a little bit more. They're showing me paper and contracts and possibilities of things that need to be signed, or paperwork that's got to be completed, or you know, something that's got to be filled in and sent off, or something like that. It's like, ugh, the ink's not dry yet, or something like that, and just wait until the ink is dry, so to speak. Okay, so triumph. Yeah, you're feeling actually quite triumphant within yourself, even though things are still quite choppy, because there is the potential around you now beginning to appear for something new that changes things, which is brilliant. So it's probable that it's sort of towards the end of June that things start to pick up a little bit and feel a little bit more possible and feasible, like the last week. And then you know, because that's really when we start getting into Cancer anyway, the cancer energy. And then the end of June, beginning of July, and most of July is when it starts to feel like, okay, maybe I can make something work with this. Oh, I forgot to put the timer on for you as well. Just have to guess it. Right, so you're moving out of a period of having to stand your ground, having to be really clear about who you are, what you want, and what you feel is right for you, even if you don't know exactly what it is that you're going to do just yet. It's like saying, well, this isn't right for me. You know, sometimes you know what's right by knowing what's not right, and it's been a bit like that. It's been like cutting away and cutting away and cutting away at situations, you know, in work or in ideas or in groups or even in relationships, where you think, well, I've got to just be really clear about my vision, and I can't allow anything to throw me off course. And, you know, rightly or wrongly, you've chosen to get very, very clear about what you don't, what you What stabilizes you? What destabilizes you? And therefore, what stabilizes you? I see a picture of 2 feet, and they almost seem as if they're sort of wearing clay shoes. And it's as if you've been given that by your own guides for a while. So if you felt as if you've been walking really slowly through things, it's not that you've been walking slowly. It's that they've been grounding you and trying to give you a fixed sense of your own truth and what the path that you have to walk and the way that only you can walk that path. And stand your ground, you know, is a perfect way of describing that. So that's the phase that you're just coming out of. What are you moving into? Moving into a much more intuitive phase. Much more intuition and less thinking is what I'm hearing. More intuition and less thinking. So less relying on logic, less trying to plan things out and think, well, okay, I've got to fix this because I need to sort that out and I've got to pay this for that and do this for that. When it comes to the material, you need to be much more flowing and intuitive. That's the sense that I've got with this, okay? So we started off talking about how you needed to feel safe to go back out into the world. So I do want to keep coming back to that because I feel like I've got to pull all these threads back to that single point here, because really that's what the reading is all about. It's about how can we get Libra back out there into the world, feeling that all the things that are on the table, so to speak, have been taken care of, and so I can actually step out and know that they're done and dusted. So, okay, trust your intuition. Memories of love. Okay, so you're feeling a little bit nostalgic about something, feeling a bit, looking back on something, looking back on past love, wondering whether, you know, things could have worked out or should have or would have, and, you know, just feeling a little bit at sea, a little bit bruised, a little bit of healing still needs to happen in that respect. Or it could be that you're looking way, way back at a time that now in context looks like it could have been a lot better than you'd given it credit for, like you know, memories of lost innocent love, a love that was before a time of turmoil and upheaval. Or it could be that you've looked back, or you're looking back over a number of different love possibilities and wondering whether, you know, that if I'd taken that road, would, you know, where would I have gone if I'd taken that road? And what Spirit is saying is stop thinking, because even thinking about love, you're being quite technical in your, you know, you're kind of trying to make sense of something that can't be made sense of. Just flow much more, because all of these things, these experiences, they've opened you up in a way that all the planning and thinking in the world could not have done. They've opened you up so that you can be much more intuitive and flowing and guided. So in July, the key for you to actually move forward, I've literally got you like going out without knowing that all that everything's going to work. It's almost like you're going out into this situation and you're going to give some sort of presentation, and you're not allowed to take any notes with you. You've just got to wing it, so to speak, or channel it or whatever. You've kind of got to embrace life a little bit like that. You've kind of got to embrace your work a little bit like that. And you've kind of got to embrace your whole loving essence a lot more like that. Less planning, less thinking, and more flowing. Okay, I hope that's making sense, because it really feels important for you in July to get this right, Libra, and to really trust that Spirit have got your back. And look at this, prosperity begins. This is what we've got in your environment. So it's almost like you can do it, don't mess it up. Okay, I know it's a weird way to describe things, but that's what I said. I kind of heard, you know, don't mess it up in the background. So just trust that it's there for you. And, you know, I'm being drawn to these hands, the way that they are being held over this little seed. And it looks in a way as if they're giving it Reiki, giving it healing, or they could be pressing the soil down and helping it to, you know, be stabilized. But I also got a sense when I looked at it that they were sort of saying, look, I'm keeping it under my hat for the time being, you know, as we mentioned before. So, and it's a very fruitful time for you. if you trust your intuition. So I'm sure that will make sense to you. Okay, hopes and fears. Don't be afraid to be alone. On the, you know, this hopes and fears card, it, to me, I don't have a problem with this because you can very easily want and desire something very powerfully and also fear it at the same time. Because let's face it, when it comes to manifesting, there's always those things existing simultaneously. The thing that you really, 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 really want and the thing that you really, 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 really don't want. And sometimes they're the same thing. We just have to find the balance within ourselves. So to focus, bring our focus in the right way so that it becomes an exciting thing rather than a thing to be feared. I hope that's making sense. Two sides of the same coin. So on the one hand, you feel you need solitude to do what you have to do. You really, really, really want it. You're really, really hoping that you finally get some time and space to put together your master plan. And at the same time, you're a little bit scared of being alone, a little bit scared of doing it on your own, and a little bit scared of, you know, how are you going to keep yourself in balance? Libras are all about the partnership, the relationship, and, you know, just trust. Just trust what's out there for you. Just trust what you find in the moments of solitude, because the universe is waiting, trying, hoping to bring you something greater than you can even imagine at this point. Okay, so if you need to be alone for a little while, be alone and see what you find in the aloneness. And your outcome, suffering in silence, let's see another one, awareness. Okay, all right. Please don't suffer in silence. What this actually says is that you may have too much on your plate at the moment. There may be too many things for you to deal with, and it may be that this is to do with the material changes that have been going on, that you feel, I need to take on all of this. If I don't take on all of this, I'm not going to be able to manage. I've got to do all of these things. Whereas what's actually happening is another plan, a divine plan, a higher plan is opening up, whereby if you move from a place of awareness, you will see that prosperity has already begun. You will allow yourself to see where that prosperity is, and you will therefore nurture that, walk towards it, and allow it to grow in your reality. It might be that you need to continue with this sense of being burdened for a tiny little bit longer, but what's actually coming out of it is the awareness. You know, awareness trumps effort, basically, in July, is what I'm feeling. That sometimes you've got to clear the decks and say, right, I'm not doing that anymore, I'm not doing that anymore, I'm not doing that anymore. Just for a couple of months, I'm not doing all those extraneous things that are just bringing in sort of little bits of this and little bits of that and giving me that sense of scarcity. I'm going to elevate my consciousness. I'm going to raise myself up in awareness so that I can see that I'm this greater being, and I can allow myself to see where the prosperity is and where the opportunity is for me to really grow. And then if you do that, let's see what else is there. Ah, it's like a magic trip. It's just bizarre, isn't it? Material harvest. Okay, your material harvest will come away from effort and suffering and into awareness, growing into awareness. And yeah, that's it. Right, let's have a quick look and see what... Okay, not those. We've got angels, gods and goddesses, my guys have just said, for the Libras, because they are currently trying to evolve into greater god awareness, goddess awareness, awareness of the higher self, and living with the complete embodiment of the higher self. That's interesting. Don't know where that came from. Okay, well, yes, I do know where that came from. You're right, guides, I do know where that came from. Let's go. Past. Goddess of the shadows. What you perceive to be your dark side is a hidden treasure. So, Libra, learn from the past. And this is, I feel, to do with weaknesses in relationships, partnerships, anywhere that you feel that you've been betrayed or betrayed yourself or anything at all of that nature that feels like murky waters. Trust yourself, your higher self, and what it has been leading you to in terms of what you need to learn and how you need to grow in this lifetime. It could be that what presses your buttons most in relationships is what shows you how you are about to take a quantum leap now in terms of your overall development, in terms of not overthinking, in terms of not overplanning, in terms of growing into awareness and away from suffering and struggle. Okay, that's, I'm going to just leave that there because I know that you already know what that issue is. Okay. Present, goddess of strength, that's lovely. Stand up for what you believe and you will gain respect by holding your ground. So we've got stand your ground again, basically. Isn't that interesting? Stand your ground. Speak up for what you deserve. Don't be afraid. Okay, I'm going to stick my neck out here. I do not want anyone to go risking things too much as a result of this, but don't be afraid to stand up and say, okay, I can't do that task anymore because I deserve more. I deserve more for doing that task, or I deserve more time to focus on the tasks that will bring me more. Either way, there's a conversation that needs to be had, or something needs to shift in terms of how you see your work or how you see things and what you will allow yourself to spend time on, because I just see this bigger vision calling you, and this bigger vision that's calling you will give you everything that you need ultimately. So slowly start to ease your way out of the small time stuff. Angel of emergence, it's time for the real you to emerge. There you go, Libra. Have a fantastic month in July, and I'll see you in August. If you'd like to book a reading with me, check out the links below the video. Take care. Speak to you soon. Bye.